Hello, my dear 7th class students. Welcome back to your English 2 literature class. Today we will write chapter 3, The Three Musketeers and the Fourth. As we have completed chapter 1 and 2 and the poem, so let us begin with the chapter The Three Musketeers and the Fourth. So before we start here, let me tell something about the author who has written this story. Okay, so this is just this story is been brought from a novel that is The Three Musketeers by the French novelist Alexandre Dumas. So let me tell you something about the author. Alexandre Dumas was born on July 24, 1802 in Villers-Cotterets, France. He adopted the last name Dumas from his grandmother, a former Haitian slave. Dumas established himself as one of the most popular and prolific authors in France, known for plays and historical adventure novels such as The Three Musketeers and The Count of Monte Cristo. He died on December 5, 1870 in Paris, France. His works have been translated into more than 100 languages and adapted for numerous films. So this is all about the author Alexandre Dumas. So now let us begin the chapter. The Three Musketeers and the Fourth. The Three Musketeers, published in 1844, is a novel by the French novelist Alexandre Dumas. It recounts the adventure of the Arrington, a villager who leaves home with a dream of becoming a musketeer in the army of King Louis XIII. The musketeers are responsible for protecting the French royal family, and only the best among the brave are given the honorable title. So my dear students, what do you understand by the musketeers? They are the soldiers who holds long guns, no? Okay, so they are the soldiers, okay? So here these counts here about the three musketeers. Story about a musketeer and a person named Darrington, a villager, okay, who leaves home with a dream to become a musketeer in the army of King Louis XIII. And the musketeers are responsible for protecting the French royal family, and only the best among the brave are given the honorable title. So Darrington carries a letter of introduction, because as you know that he wants to become a musketeer, and he carries a letter of introduction to the captain of the king's here king's musketeers. But on the way to Paris, he is beaten up and the letter of introduction is stolen from him. So as he was going to become a musketeer, okay, so he just had a letter of introduction to the captain of the king's. So in that way, when he was going to the way on the way to the Paris, he is beaten up and the letter of introduction which he was supposed to submit to the captain of the king's Louis is stolen from him. Okay, still he somehow manages to reach the city, means where, the Paris, where he was supposed to go. While in Paris, Darrington sees the person who had robbed him. Okay, so he founds the person who has taken the letter of introduction from him. He chases the robber, but while doing so he was just back of him to catch him, the robber, he rudely bumps into an already injured Athos, a famous musketeer. So he becomes very rudely, he becomes face to face to an already injured Athos. He is also a famous musketeer. He then gets into argument with two other musketeers, Porthos and Aramis. So here there were three musketeers known as Athos, Porthos and Aramis. Okay, so this so here the three great musketeers challenge him to a duel at a nearby convent. Duel means what? A formal fight with the weapons between two people used in the past to settle a quarrel. Okay, so as he just very rudely he bumped into the injured musketeer Athos. Okay, so he gets an argument. Who gets here? Darrington. Okay, he gets into argument with two other musketeers, and now these three musketeers, okay, they give a challenge to him to a duel at a nearby convent. Darrington and Athos draw their swords, so as it was a challenge for him, okay, now they started to fight with each other. Darrington and Athos draw their swords and get ready to fight. Now read on to find out what happened. So let us find out what happened after this when he get involved with the fight with the one of the musketeers. When you are ready, sir, at your service, sir. So one of the musketeers asking, are you ready? starting to just, okay, the two swords, how they cling together, okay? So, cling together when a company of guards commanded by, here, M.D. Zizak entered. So, a commander person entered inside when they were ready to fight. The guards sheath your words, gentlemen, sheath your swords. So, what did the guards say? Sheath your swords, means put the sword inside the cover, okay? No need to fight, you just put inside the cover. Gentlemen, sheath your swords. Let us go to the next page. But it was too late. The two combatants had been seen in a position which left no doubt in the minds of the guards. So it was already too late because they went into the argument. Okay, to fight with each other. Now the two combatants mean to people involved in the battle. Already they started to fight. Had been seen in a position, that means they already in the position to fight, which had left no doubt in the minds of the guard. Means already the guard came to know that these two musketeers were ready to fight. Hello, there you musketeers, fighting again. What about the edict, gentlemen? You know it is illegal to fight without it. So sheathe your swords and follow us. So what did the guard say here? They said that it is, you are fighting again, you started your fighting. What about the edict? Edict means an official order or statement of permission that they have to get it for fighting, okay? But it was not with them, isn't it? So here, what about the edict, gentlemen? You know it is illegal to fight without it. If you don't have any a statement or permission, an official permission, then it is illegal to fight with each other. So sheath your swords and follow us. Yes, keep your swords inside the cover and follow us. Athos moved closer to Porthos and Aramis, okay? The three musketeers, okay? I shall not be taken by these soldiers again. There are five of them and three of us, but we shall fight them even if they kill us. So what did one of the musketeers said? I shall not be taken by these soldiers, okay? They are the five of them, they are five in number and we are only three. So we shall fight with them and even if they kill us also, we have to fight with them and get the escape from them. While Zizak drew up his soldiers, Darrington made a quick decision. Gentlemen, I think there is some mistake. I think we are four, not three. So immediately when Zizak drew up the soldiers, when he went to get the soldiers, here he made, Darrington just made a quick decision. And what did he say to the other three musketeers? He said that you are mistaken. You are not three, we are four. But you are not one of us. I may not have the uniform, but I have the spirit. My precious heart is that of a musketeer. I can feel it. Answer, okay. So what he says here, I may not, because musketeers they have uniform, and here he was not having the uniform. He was not in the uniform. He says that I am not in the uniform, but I have that spirit of that musketeer's life, okay? That personality, I have it. I have the spirit. My precious heart is that of a musketeer. I can feel it. Answer, okay. The three musketeers hesitated a little because the Arantan was so young, but agreed to his he was too young to fight with the soldiers and guards, but still here he agreed to join these three musketeers. So, well then, Athos, Porthos, Aramis and Arakthan forward. Yes, now these four of them, just they were forwarding, means going front to fight with the soldiers. Okay, my dear students, so for this, today it is enough. Okay, so we'll just go for the next video. You will see the remaining part of the chapter. So just go through the two pages, read and try to understand. Thank you.